Hello everyone, and you're watching Sharing Vietnam on VTC 10 NETVIET. Ted, it's coming so close, and Vietnamese people are getting into the last stages of preparation before Ted. And on today's program, we are going to have the talk with His Excellency's Mr. Ted OSIUS, the new ambassador of the U.S. to Vietnam. He will share with us more about his feeling, impression about the culture and the tradition of the Vietnamese people welcoming Ted holiday. And first of all, why don't we have a look at our following reportage in order to know more about our new U.S. ambassador.
U.S. Ambassador to Vietnam, Ted OSIUS, started his tenure in Vietnam from December last year. This is not the first time he received tasks in Vietnam. Previously, he served as political attache at the U.S. Consulate General in Ho Chi Minh City and the Hanoi's embassy since 1996. Despite a new take on this role, this Vietnamese fluency and travel enthusiast ambassador has shown special love and desire to experience the culture and traditions of Vietnam.
Quê tôi ở bang Maryland, con quê của Clayton, bang đôi của tôi ở bang Michigan. Tôi đã được đi thăm nhiều nơi ở Việt Nam. Tôi đã đạp xe từ Bắc vào Nam, qua Huế, Đà Nẵng, Hội An và Nha Trang. Tôi rất mong sẽ một lần nữa được đạp xe qua những thành phố đó để gặp lại những người bạn đã từng đón tiếp và trò chuyện với tôi.
As you can see, we are so happy that we are invited to the resident of the ambassador today in order to talk with him and know more about his feeling for this time welcoming Ted in Vietnam. And please join me in welcoming the U.S. ambassador to Vietnam, Mr. Ted OSIUS. First of all, thank you so much for welcoming us as your residents, and congratulations at your new post.
Chúc mừng năm mới. Thank you.
As far as I know, it's not your first time serving as a U.S. official in Vietnam. So may you share with us about some of your feelings and story about Vietnam?
Yes. This is my third Tet in Vietnam, but it's for us as a family. It's our first time here as a family, and it's my first time to experience Tet as the U.S. ambassador. In my very first Tet was in Hanoi. And on day one, of course, it's devoted to respect for grandparents, and day two for parents. And on day three, my students, I had a number of young students who I taught English, they came and they brought the peach blossom branches, and they brought some very nice gifts of food, and they shared with me Tet, because I was their teacher. And it also taught me that Vietnamese respect family and they respect teachers, and therefore education is a very important value for Vietnamese. And I found that was very instructive. That helped me understand Vietnamese culture.
Before having more talk with the U.S. ambassador to Vietnam, Mr. Ted OSIUS, why don't we follow him into the kitchen and see how he prepare the chiên kek for this Tet holiday?
This is the first new year of His Excellency Ted OSIUS with his spouse and young son in Vietnam. Bustling atmosphere in the small kitchen at the ambassador's mansion. He has invited a Vietnamese friend, Madame Hung Nhi, to guide his family on how to make bánh chưng, a traditional custom of the Vietnamese Tet holiday. Through every step of the making process, Madame Hung Nhi has shown the significance of each ingredient, each stage of the making.
Làm lỏng quá cái thì nó cũng ảnh hưởng đến cuộc sống của mình. Nên chính cái bánh chưng này là nói lên cái cuộc sống của những người phụ nữ ở nhà ấy. bên chưa là đất
yêu thương của đất và yêu thương của trời. Thế
nhưng nếu mà bạn nào làm bằng khuôn ấy thì em không cầm vào và cái tay như thế này.
Chung cake rolled up tightly and cleverly. Madame Hong Yi still went on with her humor about the cooking scene between the mother-in-law and wife drama during Tet, since often the women in the family play a key role in the cooking for Tet. Hence, there are times the tightness of wrapping could be used to guess the mind of the rapper. Often, if the daughter-in-laws are sad or in trouble, she would wrap tightly, and vice versa. If she is happy, the twist could be looser. Currently, the custom of making chung cake is not popular in many modern families in Vietnam, but on the feast of every home, Rang chung is an indispensable dish. A specialty of the New Year Fest is laid out to the ambassador's family so they can fully enjoy the taste of Tet. Jams, pighead paste, red sticky rice, bánh chưng are indispensable without pickled onions. This New Year of the ambassador seemed to be properly in tune with Vietnamese spirit, enjoying your homemade food next to your family in the vibrancy of peach blossom.
Welcome back to the talk today with Mr. Ted OSIUS, the U.S. ambassador to Vietnam. So what are your feelings when you have just tried to make chung cake for the first time in your life?
I think we both enjoyed it. Madame Hong Yi was very careful in the way she taught it because it was the way her mother taught her. So she was teaching us to do what her mother taught her. And she was telling us, as she did it, what it meant. She told us the meaning of the Do Sang. She told us the meaning of the Thịt Heo. We talked about Lang Liu and the original Ban Chung that made Lang Liu into the king. And she explained each part of it as part of a family tradition. And so I felt in the making of the Ban Chung, there's an expression of Vietnamese respect for family.
What do you think about the story that your friend have just told you, why she teach you how to make the chung cake?
Well, I was struck by the fact that Madame Hong Yi's mother taught her to make the ban chung. And as she described each part of it, even the twisting, it's bringing two pieces into one. It's all about family. And the symbolism, I think, is very beautiful. So what it tells me is that Vietnamese values very much center on family. Respect for grandmother and grandfather, respect for father and mother, and valuing family and what's important about family. And I think the time of making the ban chung is a special time for the family. So for us, it was also very special.
What do you think about the way that Vietnamese people preserve their culture and tradition, especially during Tet holiday?
Well, I have a lot of respect for it because actually I think in many ways we share many of those values. We care, people of the United States also care a lot about family. They care about looking after their parents. They care about the children learning what's important in life. And so I have a lot of respect for each of the aspects of Vietnamese culture, and particularly for Tet, because Tet, I think, is very central to what is important in Vietnamese culture.
May you share with us some of your intention for this Tet?
We went to the temple, and we were able, yesterday with our son, we released the carp into Ho Tay, and we have enjoyed making the ban chung, and we will celebrate Tet as a family. We will go with our family to Hoi An, because Hoi An we think is a very special and beautiful place in Vietnam, and we thought it would be a nice place to celebrate as a family.
So serving as the U.S. ambassador to Vietnam on this very special occasion when the two countries celebrate the 20th anniversary of the diplomatic relation, what are your feelings and what are your comments also on the bilateral relation?
I think it's a great opportunity. We've made huge progress in 20 years, and Vietnam has made huge progress in 20 years. So coming back here and seeing how much more prosperous and how much more modern, and the changes in Vietnam, I think, are very, very impressive. But the traditions remain the same and remain important in Vietnam. And so I think to celebrate Tet in a Vietnam that's stronger and more prosperous is wonderful. And I think this year we'll have a chance to have many high-level visits back and forth, and we'll have a chance to deepen our partnership in important areas such as education and science and technology, and above all, trade and commerce. I think this is the year that we'll have the Trans-Pacific Partnership Agreement that will tie our two countries closer together.
Last but not least, may you share with us your wishes for the bilateral relation in 2015 and also your wishes for our audience.
On behalf of the President of the United States, as Ambassador to Vietnam, I would like to wish all people who care about Vietnam health, happiness, and prosperity in this new year. The United States hopes for Vietnam that it will be strong, independent, and prosperous, and respect the rule of law and human rights. And that will make for a deep partnership between the United States and Vietnam.
Once again, thank you so much for spending time with Sharing Vietnam. We hope that you will have an amazing Tet holiday in Vietnam. That's all we have for today, and we want to remind you that later during the Tet holiday, we will have one more talk with the U.S. Ambassador to Vietnam, Mr. Ted Osius, on Sharing Vietnam. So stay tuned. If you have any question or recommendation, please send us an email to sharingvietnam@netviettv.net. Thank you so much, and we wish you a happy Tet holiday. Sure.